Welcome back. Well, we had a lot happen in our FCS world over the weekend. So to talk a little more about Saturday and what we can take from that, we bring in our FCS experts. That's Brian Shawn up in West Fargo, Alex Heinert in Grand Forks, and here in Sioux Falls, Jay Elsen and Tom Nieman. So Brian, we'll start with you. A happy weekend in Fargo, a big win for the Bison, but a certain player back from injury and appears to be in midseason form. So talk a little bit about Nick DeLuca's return.
Yeah, I think it really gave the defense a big boost for North Dakota State. You know, DeLuca's one of those guys. They weren't sure when he got hurt, when or if he'd be back this season. For him to be back by the conference opener in September against Missouri State, you know, you're talking about an All-American guy that may be the best defensive player, or certainly one of the best in the country, coming back, and he hits nine tackles, makes a big tackle for loss on a goal line stand, and I think just his presence on the field really changes North Dakota State defensively. Unfortunately, they lose his backup, Dan Marlette, who filled in very admirably the last 2 weeks due to an ACL tear in the game against Missouri State. So you get DeLuca back, but you lose Marlette, unfortunately, at that position.
Yeah, good news and bad news. Bison also notched their 700th win, but let's move to the Fighting Hawks. Alex, not as happy of a weekend for UND, and 13 starters injured, and you also said that there are a few more that are questionable for, you know, the upcoming schedule. So is there any more bad luck that UND can take?
Yeah, well, first of all, yeah, it's ridiculous, and it's kind of becoming a broken record here. I mean, in terms of injury really affecting their performance, they hit that tipping point against USD, and that was 3 weeks and seven or eight major injuries ago. The secondary and linebacking core have really taken the biggest hit. Both of those groups are down three starters, again, two of which were All-Americans, by the way. And it's really showed. UND has given up 45 or more points now for three games in a row. That's something that has never happened in program history. And they've gone from the best rush defense in the conference to the worst. And to compound the matter, their offense also struggling a bit, last in the Big Sky in points per game and total offense. Now, with all that said, and granted I said this last week, but there's still a lot of talent and a lot of belief on this team that things can still turn around. I know they're 1-4. That's not great. But the last time they lost three straight games was in 2015, and they responded with a great three-game winning streak to finish the year 7-4. I'm not saying that it's going to happen. I'm just saying I wouldn't give up on this team just yet.
I'm just saying. Well, maybe history will repeat itself. All right, moving down I-29 to South Dakota. We're actually in Ohio. South Dakota State suffered a 19-7 loss at Youngstown State. Tom, you were there. Some historic lows set in this game.
I wish I would not have been there. Yeah, it was bad. The Jacks ran 37 plays in this game. Their time of possession was 14 minutes and 46 seconds out of 60 minutes. Those are the lowest numbers in those categories for South Dakota State as a Division I program. Going back to 2004, it was bad on both sides. The Jacks have only been held under 20 minutes of possession two other times since 2004, but never under 15 minutes like they were in this game. They got some things going early, as you can see on this first drive, but they fumbled there. But anyway, did not run enough plays. They've averaged 72 offensive plays per game in the Missouri Valley Conference the last couple of years. They only ran 37 in this game. Youngstown State had all kinds of long drives. It was bad on both sides of the football. So the only bright thing, I guess you could say, for Jacks fans is maybe this is the low point. Got to be the low point in the last 14 years, and it gets better from here. But it was bad on both sides.
It could be. Youngstown's a good team, though.
Youngstown is very good, and it's going to be a great game this weekend.
Yeah, I was going to say, we're about to see them in the Dome. But let's end on a positive note. USD was rolling early in that Western Illinois game, but then Western starts to creep back in. I don't think I was the only one that was having flashbacks to last year. But USD, the difference, they finished this one out. They won the game on the road, big road win. So how different is this 2017 team?
Yeah, well, you definitely weren't the only one. For those of us that were in attendance, it felt very familiar because we did see them blow significant leads a couple of different times last year. But I think therein lies the difference between this team and that team. And they've still got a ways to go in terms of closing football games out. But, you know, getting beat deep here. Jalen Acklin had a huge day. The safety struggled a bit. It almost felt like they were trying too hard not to get beaten deep, and it ends up happening. He piles up 19 catches for 343 yards and three touchdowns on the day. Just a superhuman effort from him. Big punt return that helped swing the momentum as well. Just, it kind of started to snowball and get out of control. The difference, though, getting back to that, is that this team figured it out. When they needed to make a play down the stretch of the football game, they made the one play that mattered. Danny Rambo making the pick on the last offensive snap of the game for Western Illinois. And I don't think that would have happened last year. And so, you know, they certainly were wobbling but they didn't fall over. And that was the big difference and the big reason why they're still 4-0. So it was a pretty good performance for 2.5 quarters. Got pretty dicey over the last 20 minutes, but they figured it out. They got it done.
So going into this weekend matchup, I mean, we don't want to preview it too much, but Tom, you just saw a Youngstown State team, and Jay, I mean, at the Dakota Dome this weekend, yeah. It's going to be a highly anticipated
I'm going to be
matchup.
Glued. Youngstown State is very good up front. They pretty much manhandled South Dakota State. Coyotes, though, defensively, I think, are much better than they were a year ago. It's going to be interesting to see. Youngstown will probably play their backup quarterback, their running quarterback, so to speak, against USD's defense. I'm going to be glued to this game. It's going to be great.
Yeah, USD held Western Illinois under 40 yards total on the ground. Obviously, a strength of Youngstown State. They want to be physical. They want to hold the football. You got to be two-dimensional to be able to hold the football. And so that, you know, that matchup is going to dictate how this football game goes. If Youngstown consistently moves the chains like they did last week against South Dakota State, could be a long day for USD. If they play, though, against the run like they did against Western, they're going to be in pretty good shape.
All right. Well, great insight, great discussion as always, guys. Thank you so much. All right, coming up after the break, we take it to the high school scene. Jody Norstedt breaks down the prep football action from this past weekend in North Dakota and then hands out a game ball. Later, it's Athlete Tweets. Stay right here.